Oh, a little bit wet. Yeah, I should just turn this on after I got through this awful part. Anyway, all right. Smiling Andy. Yeah, it's just no low that he won't go to. He just keeps doing the same things over and over again. So it's like the cult card and the Hitler card almost in every video. The tyranny of the truth. And the truth is the evil of opinion. You know, you can't have an opinion. There's no such thing as a correct answer to an ethical question. We can't know that rape is wrong. We can't know that slavery is wrong. We can't impose it. That's tyranny. Like I said, these things are all things that were already brought up. It's like we didn't even say them. No response whatsoever. No acknowledgement that argument's been made. It's in your face. Are you going to call the North in the circumstance of the Civil War tyrants? Is that going to be how you describe their edict? Their imposition of a fundamental rational truth? When they banned witch burning, was that tyranny? Was it tyranny that some mob couldn't decide you're a witch and burn you to death? Huh? You know, come on. We know where the tyranny is. You're the tyrants. You're the assholes saying, well, because all of us are alike and we all think this is a fun ride, we're going to kidnap people out of nowhere and shove them into our delusion. And your delusion is a reality, okay? It's not like, this is like the Matrix, except the people aren't batteries, right? They're not stored somewhere and you're liberating them from the Matrix. No, you're dragging them into your delusion of accomplishment. Look, we're having this intergalactic battle with the machines, and because we want to fight not to be batteries, and Mr. Smith is a bully, and so you got to come and help us. No, I don't. Fuck you. I don't have to think your stupid idiotic cause is worth anything, and I don't have to think your stupid human race is worth anything. You can't make a logical argument defending the human race is worth anything. Just as you can't make an argument could you drag me, you know, create me in a test tube and then plant me on Mars and say, well, you have an obligation. Yeah, we think Martian is a good idea. Well, you be a Martian. Well, fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. Who the hell do you think you are, you stupid shit? You're the tyrant. You're the imposer. So again, you just ignore the facts of the circumstance and, you know, create your own delusion of tyranny because somebody doesn't allow you to be a tyrant. I mean, it's so freaking ludicrous. Oh, yeah, we're not going to allow you to be tyrants. Oh, that's tyranny. Well, no, I don't think it is. I think that's untyranny. Yeah, that's what I think that is. Untyranny. So anyway, that part's a joke. All right, so this, you know, this subject is just keeps reoccurring of this idea that we don't know anything. And the only people who show themselves to know anything are apparently the only people. As soon as you say you know something, you're religious. You know, you can't say I know something, present the evidence for it, like the human genome, or, you know, a ton of fossil evidence, or something else, and say, yeah, this is why I know it. Okay? I don't know it because a god whispered it in my ear. I don't know it because of a special decoder ring that only me and my friends have. And that's how we know it. I'm not saying I know it because the angel of, you know, whatever, Gabriel, came down and he blew a horn in my ear. What other example? I don't know it through some false bullshit, some truther theory. No, I know it and I give you the evidence of my knowledge of it. Every bit of the evidence of my knowledge of it. All the rational conclusions and logic that make me believe it. And I say, I can't understand how you don't get it. Look at the fucking evidence, retard. There it is, right in front of you. I mean, I can't help it if you're retarded. I can't help it if you're too stupid to put it in your calculator and get the correct results, because it's right there. The variables have been filled in. Here's the fucking equation. It's not that goddamn complicated. And the only way you can escape it is to do something completely ludicrous, like saying, suffering isn't bad. what do you mean it isn't bad? You crazy fuck. So look at your desperate effort to escape the logic, to escape the equation and the product. You run from it so hard that you'll destroy something as undeniably true as the fact that suffering is a bad conscious experience, a negative conscious state, and that should be avoided, prevented, ameliorated. Oh, I mean, just amazing. Damn, I hope the screen doesn't go too high. Damn, a little more water than I expected still. More water than I expected. Even more water. Damn it. Might get in my way. Yeah, I gotta go. Yeah, this is distracting. Water is such a pain in the ass sometimes in the wrong places. Oh, the trouble it can cause. Anyway, so it's, you know, it's always trying to slander this philosophy with a label that's totally can't be defended rationally. And it's obscene that you people would resort to this. To call it a cult or religion is just obscene. There is nothing coming close to dogma. Every fact is there to be challenged. Nothing is being stated as authoritative beyond the fact that Dawkins said it or some other scientist has validated the elements of that truth. Yes, they might not state the conclusion, but they will verify the fundamental, foundational facts. And it's just, it is so slimy. Such a lousy, rotten tactic to sit there and imply that it's dogma to believe in evolution. Really, that's what you're saying. You're saying that's dogma. Evolution is dogma. It's not dogma. It's scientifically verified, rational conclusion. It's the only logically meritorious theory of creation. It's not a dogmatic religion. It's not religious theory. And the rational consequences of evolution, every bit of antinatalism is fundamentally an outcropping of that consequence. Because evolution itself is an unmeritorious process of change. The change isn't based on merit. The evolution isn't in a rational, coherent direction. The direction is best consumer. This is not a good thing. To find the best Kmart shopper is not exactly something you can say, well, here's a process that will find the best Kmart shopper in the world. Well, who the fuck cares? I mean, as meaningless as the Olympics is, knowing who the best Kmart shopper is even more meaningless. And that's what we're involved in as evolving creatures. And the catch thing of merit is the fact that one of our tools is intelligence. And intelligence does have value, intrinsically, fundamentally. It's a valuable tool in defining reality and the truth. And that has value. That has value that, as the word goes, what's the word they use when something goes past its function? They use it all the time, and now I finally got a chance to use it, and I can't remember the damn thing. Impasses. Well, anyway, it goes beyond the its origins. So it's a great tool created by a dumb process. And the irony is, though, is that great tool when given the facts, can only conclude that there's nothing to do here but clean up messes. And the source of the mess is sentience. It creates the negative value that needs to be converted into a positive. It needs to be converted out of its negative function through our action. We create the negative, then we use our intelligence to manage some portion of it, but we end up with a net loss because our management can never be perfect enough. And that's the catch of this living thing. There's nothing to do but satisfy a need that doesn't need to exist. That statement in itself can't be unraveled logically. It's a truth. These are creating needs that don't need to exist is not a good idea. There's no function in it. Creating a problem so you can solve it is not rational. It's not reasonable. It's not logical. And it's not dogma that says so. It's logic that says so. And it's perfectly graspable by our fucking intelligence. Even though our intelligence spends most of its time preoccupied with scheming for our selfish identity, it is quite capable of handling a logical equation now and then, a rational bit of thinking that isn't completely selfishly motivated or selfishly context. We can make judgments about the sensibility of things. And if we judge our existence, we judge our lives as a individual, as a kind, as a thing, a living thing, we can quite obviously see that it doesn't function, it doesn't provide a service to the universe, that it only cleans up some portion of the mess it makes, and that the sensible thing to do, it's insufficiently efficient. Another sentence, another connection of three words, insufficiently efficient. It's only two words that you can't unravel. It's logically sound. It's an accurate description of the circumstance. We are consuming more harm than we are producing good. It's just a fact. Anyway. But it's not stated as God says so. It's just stated as, here's my collection of facts, here's the collection of my personal experience, and here's my interpretation that points decidedly in saying one thing. This is the only logical road. This is the only way to fix an unethical equation. Again, even if it was only one sentience that was suffering, that had to pay the entire price, it still wouldn't be worth it. Because you still couldn't come up with a rational argument to justify that imposition. That imposition would still be unethical. You can't joyride on someone else's nickel. It has to be your nickel. And it is a joyride. It has no necessity. All you can argue for is that you want some positive value fun. You can't argue from necessity. And so unless you're rescuing something in the universe, unless you're saving something from suffering, you can't justify imposing the suffering. It's like the only defense for torture is that you're going to prevent more people from being tortured. You know, that kind of... It's that kind of dilemma. I mean, these logical statements are sound. This isn't cult rhetoric. This isn't the UFOs are coming. I just feel it in my heart. That's not the kind of argument being made here. So you have, it's just an evidence of your low integrity that you would resort to such cheap shot Hitler card, cult card, bullshit to defend your nonsense. Stand up like a man and make a real argument. I mean, to even bring up, Joan of Arc in your argument, and Aristotle, and all these people you bring up. I mean, you know, you're such a coward in argumentation. You should have no right to even use their names. You show no honor. You show no integrity. I mean, you're just a despicable, slimy, lying piece of shit. I mean, fuck. That's reason enough to run you through for that offense alone. Taking their names and saying you're going to carry their sword into the future and fight tyranny. Yeah, fuck you, you goddamn tyrant. You goddamn imposer of the imposition. Fuck you. You despicable lowlife. Despicable sub. You're an insult to intelligence. I've said it before, you're an insult to the only thing that gives human beings any merit at all, and that's intelligence. Because intelligence loves integrity. Intelligence loves the truth. Intelligence has an honor code to the facts, and you show them no honor. Especially when they've been shoved right in your face, put right in front of you, and you have found slimy excuses to hide them under the napkin or slide your plate over it and pretend the argument's never been made. I mean, really. Fuck you, Andy. You suck. You double suck. Fucker. I mean, really. Yeah. That's enough. But really, what slimy bullshit. I mean, the good news is it's so slimy that anybody with even a little bit of integrity should be smelling your crap by now. Cult tyrant. Yeah, right. Fuck you, imposer. So, until next time. Imposter, too. You know, veiling yourself in other people's honor robes. Fuck you.